In the Zoom web portal, from the left navigation under Admin, click to expand User Management and then click Users. This subsection lists all of the users within your Zoom account. But right now, this Zoom account only shows a single user, so let's get account set up for additional team members. For larger deployments with lots of users, the option to bulk import or even bulk update users is available. You would click Import here and then upload a CSV file. You create them from a spreadsheet with columns and data that match the fields in the form. Some organizations may also be able to add users from a single sign-on service. For now, I will add users manually because I only have a few people to add. To begin, click on Add User in the upper right corner. Enter the email address of each user you would like to add, separated by a comma. For user type, select Basic, License, or On-Prem. What you select depends on your account type and goals for the user. Each plan comes with the number of licensed meeting users you purchased, so you'll likely choose Basic unless you know they need enhanced capabilities and will occupy some of your licenses. Basic users on an account are unlimited. On-prem is a less common selection where users can host in the Zoom meeting connector within a company's internal network. Below, you'll see a drop-down menu indicating your license type options. This, again, will be specific to your account. In our example, we see two choices: Meeting Basic only or Meeting and Zoom Phone Basic. Select whichever option best reflects the capabilities the user will need for their job. Note that only licensed users have access to any add-on packages, so the options will appear when licensed is selected. The department, manager, job title, and location fields are optional but may be helpful later if your company decides to sort users into groups. If you've already created some groups, the option to add them will appear here too. Click Add to complete the administrative process. Zoom will send account invitations to each email address entered. It's strongly recommended that you also send a personal email ahead of time so users know what to expect and why they're receiving the email from Zoom. If the user already has a paid account associated with their email address and is being added as a licensed user, Zoom will work to resolve the time left on the account. If they're being added as a basic user, they may lose some of their previous capabilities, but Zoom will still work to resolve the time left on the account. As users complete the account creation process, their names will appear on the list of users within your account. You can edit or modify all user information after the initial setup, including upgrading to licensed if available. Simply click Edit next to the user's name. Users who have yet to complete the process will appear under Pending. You may decide you want to give them a little nudge to complete the process by resending their account invitation. Adding users to an account is the first step to many other administrative tasks. For example, assigning a Zoom phone number or elevating a member to a group admin. Thanks for watching.